Hello everyone, I am Dr. Varun Kumar, faculty of MBA from Technia Institute of Advanced Studies. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on Company Act 2013. Firstly, we will discuss the meaning of company. According to Company Act 2013, company means a company incorporated under this act or under any previous company law. In simple word, we can say joint stock company is a voluntary association of persons for profit having a capital divided into transferable share, the ownership of which is the condition of membership. Now we will discuss the features of a company. We will discuss one by one. Firstly, incorporated association. Yes, the company is an incorporated association. It must be incorporated or registered under the Company Act. Without registration, no company can come into existence. Second, separate legal existence. It is created by law and it is distinct legal entity independent of its member. It can own property, enter into contract, can file suit in its own name. Third one is perpetual existence. Death, insolvency and insanity or change of members has no effect on the life of a company. It can come to an end only through the prescribed legal procedure or legal formalities. According to the Company Act, company will be and with the winding up process. Fourth one is limited liability. Yes, of course, the member of companies have all limited liability. The liability of every member is limited to the nominal value of the share bought by him or to the amount or guaranteed by him. Fifth one, transferability of shares. Shares of public company are easily transferable, but there are certain restrictions on transfer of share of private company. Next one is common seal. It is the official signature of a company. It is affixed on all important documents of the company. Then, separation of ownership and control. Yes, according to the Company Act 2013, the ownership of company and control of the company are separate phenomena. Management of company is in the hands of elected representative of shareholders, known individually as director and collectively as board of directors. These were the features of company. Now we will discuss the merit and demerit of a company. Why a person, why a member will have to make a company? Firstly, we will discuss merits of a company. The first merit is limited liability. Limited liability of shareholder reduces the degree of risk borne by him. Second one, transfer of interest. Easily transferability of share increases the attractiveness of shares for investment. Third one, perpetual existence. Yes. Existence of a company is not affected by the death, insanity, insolvency of member or change of any member. Company can be liquidated only as per the provision of Company Act. The fourth one is scope of expansion. A company can collect huge amount of capital from unlimited number of members who are ready to invest because of limited liability, easy transferability and chances of high return. Last one, professional management. Yes. A company can afford to employ highly qualified expert in different area of business management. Now we will discuss limitations of company. The first major limitation is legal formalities. Yes, the procedure for formation of company is very long and time-taking, time-consuming, expensive and require a lot of legal formalities to be fulfilled. Second one, lack of secrecy. It is very difficult to maintain secrecy in case of public company as company is required to publish and file its annual accounts and reports. Third one is lack of motivation. Yes, divorce between ownership and control and absence of a direct link between efforts and reward lead to lack of personal interest and incentives. The fourth one is delay in decision making. Red tapism and bureaucracy do not permit quick decisions and prompt action. There is a little scope for personal initiative. Fifth one and last, oligarchic management. Company is said to be democratically managed but actually managed by few people. Board of directors, sometimes they take decisions keeping in mind their personal interest and benefits, ignoring the interest of shareholders and company. So, I hope you understand the topic of company and the essential feature of company. Thank you very much.